Hello everyone, welcome to Ether 1. This is a first-person adventure game, and I can't freaking wait to play it because I've heard really good things about it and probably more to the point. I've played it for about 10 minutes myself just to make sure it works, and I've already fallen in love with it. I just know I'm going to enjoy the hell out of this game, and I can't wait to play it. If you'd like to check it out for yourself, it's available from a bunch of different places, including the official sites, the Humble Store, GOG, and Steam. So I'll have links to all of that in the description. Alright, let's dive into it. Start new game. Alright, let's overwrite this one. Wait, what the heck? This is the first game that I played. I played for about 10 minutes. It says time played 0 hours, 0 minutes. What? Oh, it's because I never saved it past the beginning. Okay, that explains it. It's an autosave. Let's overwrite.
Hey, it's me. Listen, I'm sorry for the things I said earlier on. It's just, God, I really don't think you should go to that place. I don't think they care. Not like they should. And before you think it, I know how it feels to want to feel safe, to want more. You know I do it, but Jesus, do you know how they view you? Just another patient to squeeze money out of. Please. Don't go tonight. I'm freaking scared. For you and for me.
That's weird. It's giving me the instructions for the mouse buttons as if I'm using keyboard and mouse, but I'm actually using a controller. Anyway. Alright, so a good thing to mention right now before I get into it anymore is that I am actually using a controller for the first time ever. I've literally basically never used a controller because haven't owned a console for like 10 years, which means I'm completely unfamiliar with it, and that's actually why I'm actually using it. It's because I'm kind of training for Dark Souls 2, so I'm trying to get used to a controller. So basically I'm going to move around really poorly and I'm gonna have trouble doing stuff. But I'm trying to get used to a controller. It's very strange. This weird piece of plastic in my hand.
In the mid-19th century, advances in genetic and psychological sciences led to a series of astounding breakthroughs regarding the human genome.
Ethereal rock.
At the forefront of these experiments, the Ishin Initiative discovered and developed new ways of mapping the human mind, expanding the knowledge of our species. 1942. Whilst the world was at odds with itself, the Ishin Initiative discovered Patient Zero.
And now, this might cause some slight discomfort.
And shortly after, the Ether Institute was born. With it, a completely new way to navigate the human brain. Projection. Allowing scientists to access areas of the conscious mind previously undiscovered by medicine, placing our scientific studies at the apex of modern technology.
I was just listening to that bit over the intercom. So this game deals with the mind and memories, keeping your fondest memories alive. Discuss the benefits with your local Ether representative. The Institute of Telepathic Medicine. Really curious about that part, telepathic. We teach, they restore. You remember.
Advances in genetic and psychological sciences.
And I have no idea what the heck this thing is. I mean, I know it's the ethereal rock, but what is it?
At the forefront of these experiments.
The Ether Institute. I love the graphics too. It's got such a wonderful visual style. It's like slightly stylized. It's not completely realistic. It actually reminds me very slightly of the kind of look that the Walking Dead games and the Wolf Among Us games have. Very slightly, but not as stylized. It looks really good. Anyone here?
It is. Oh, this is excellent. We're so glad to have you back. My name is Dr. Edmonds, but you can call me Phyllis if you like. Right. There should be a register on the reception desk. So once you've signed in, grab the key card from the top drawer and head on down. You will need it to gain access to the lower floors.
Alright, so I tried to do this before, and typing with a gamepad, a controller, is horrible. I hate it. And it seems like if you're using a controller, you can't use the keyboard. I tried to type on the keyboard, it doesn't work. So I'm going to name myself something really simple, because otherwise it's going to take about a million years. Let's call myself... Yep, that's good. I'm going to call myself AJ. Oh, crap. How do I delete? There we go. Okay, AJ. Simple. There's my key card. I will take that.
Restoration procedure for patient.
JN2057.
Will commence shortly. Staff are advised to prepare chambers for initial projection.
Well, it seems you best get a move on. There's plenty to do. And for you, plenty to see and discover. I'm going to be guiding you through the process of restoration this evening, and hopefully ensuring that nothing terrible happens to you, or our client. I'm in restoration chamber number 3. Now, if you don't mind, would you be a dear and head on down?
I will gladly head on down, but only after I've gone everywhere else. So this game does have optional puzzles. Apparently you can... I think you can go through without really solving any of the puzzles at all. Or maybe it's just the more complex puzzles that you don't need to solve. But anyway, you can basically go through it as if it's just a story. And you don't have to engage with at least some of the puzzles. But you can if you choose to, and I think it reveals more about the game world. Which is absolutely what I'm going to do. I'm definitely going to solve the puzzles. Because it would drive me crazy to leave stuff undiscovered.
The Restorer. The next step in human evolution. An asset to society and a wonder of the natural world.
Oh wait, I wanted to listen to the rest of that. Talk again!
The Restorer. The next step in human evolution. An asset to society and a wonder of the natural world. Their purpose? To restructure memories within the maze of the human mind, restoring peace and harmony to our clients, projecting our ethos through their actions. What the mind thinks, the heart transmits.
Okay, so the Restorers are special. And this is the Institute of Telepathic Medicine. And I think I'm a Restorer, because she talked about a client that I think I'm supposed to be helping. So I'm going to guess that I'm probably telepathic. That's my guess anyway. Oh, press X to examine an item you're holding. Oh. There we go. Hello, keycard. You look kind of like a cassette. Actually, I just realized, that's a really thick keycard. It's probably the thickest keycard I've ever seen in my life. Look at that thing. Oh yeah, so it doesn't seem like there's an inventory system. Whoops. There we go. Yeah, it seems like there's not an inventory system. You can only hold one item at a time. So if you want to pick up something else, you might want to put this down. Just stick it there for now, I guess. Let's see. Load Ether Solution 3.5. Ether Solution 3.5 suspended due to insufficient data regarding health and safety. Ratio of positive and negative effects upon consumption is currently 1 to 2. It is worth noting that the current positive effects have shown the intended outcomes of this experiment clearly. Positive effects include a stronger, more defined focus in patients, as well as stronger cognitive skills. Negative effects, however, have shown serious problems to the consumer, in some cases causing further short-term memory loss. Ooh, that's a pretty big problem for an institute that's supposed to be restoring memory. Furthering the memory loss is, well, the exact opposite of what you want to do. look like paints or something. I wonder if that is paint. I don't know, it's really colorful. I don't really know what they are. God, using a controller is so bizarre for me. It just feels strange. Let's get some tunes. Let's listen to that while we read this. Hey, James. I have totally set up the greatest prank to get McCarthy back this weekend, especially after what he did to my sandwich last week. I found out that he always works late on Saturday evenings, usually on his own, on maintenance within restoration chamber number 3. You're not going to believe what I've cooked up. I replaced the fuse in the Rembrandt power box with the wrong type. When McCarthy comes to do the power check on the chair, it's going to make a huge bang. He's going to be scared to death. Oh, what could go wrong? Maybe give him a heart attack. Sounds perfectly harmless. Not to mention breaking company property, too. Wasting money. Naughty. Okay, what's over that way and what's over the other way? Offices and gallery. Okay, oh, restoration chamber 1 to 3. So this is where I'm supposed to go. So let's go everywhere else first. By the way, I love the sound design, too. Something as simple as the footsteps. Sound really good. Oh, right, I didn't pick up the keycard. Durr. That might be helpful. Nice thing about a controller, I have to admit, is that I can get some really smooth movements. Very cinematic. Like this. Very cool, yeah. This thing lit up when I came in, didn't it? Is this just massive light? Is that all it is? I think I'd settle for a light bulb. Seems kind of inefficient to make something so huge if it's just a light. I don't know, probably does more. It's probably a TV screen, actually. Just with nothing being displayed. Prescription 12 milligrams. What does that say? You actually can read the text, but it's too freaking small for me to read. Can I bring it closer? I don't think so. Alright, let's put that back. What is this? That's for administering it, obviously. A wonderful needle. Oh god, I don't like needles. Put it back. Put it down. Put it down. And tweezers? I get the medicine in the syringe for administering it, but why the tweezers? Test lab number 1. What's this way? Not sure. So are they doing testing on plants? I mean, there's an awful lot of plants around here. Much more than I'd expect to see if they were just decorations. I mean, they might be, but it feels like they're being used for research or something. Get stapler. Get hole puncher. Need 12 ballpoint pens, A4 paper, use stationery to write letters, use hole puncher to file letters. Use stapler to staple things. I don't know who wrote that, but I like them already. That seems like something I would write. More of these weird colored things. Okay, I don't think that's paint. I don't think there'd be upside down paint. But what the heck is it? Yeah, no, these definitely aren't just decorations. Looks like they're being washed or prepared in some way here. These plants. Wonder what for. Remember to meet in the gallery at 1 o'clock in the morning. A new projection is due to start, and it is going to be incredibly interesting. You know that accident that occurred a few weeks ago? Well, it's that same patient. Meet me in the locker room at midnight if you want to join us. Robert. 1 o'clock in the morning? Must be some sort of a secret meeting. Obviously, normal company meetings I don't think would start at 1 in the morning. Load patient zero historic log, blah blah blah. The birth of a new era occurred today. Patient zero, whom we have been working with in our projection experiments, has brought forth some very interesting results. Firstly, his ability to communicate telepathically has improved dramatically. Although at this moment in time, it is akin to a babe's ability to wail at its mother. His telekinetic ability has shown small amounts of improvement, tiny movements here and there. We even witnessed a box move across a table the other day. Fascinating implications. Projection experiments. His ability to communicate telepathically has improved dramatically. I wonder if that's just through training, or if they're giving him something. You know, like a drug. I mean, I did just see some sort of a drug there and a syringe. So, it definitely wouldn't surprise me if they're developing methods to improve to improve telepathic abilities so that they'd have new restorers. More telepathy, more money. They are a business. Report entry number 329, Doctor's Log. After the terrible incident during R157's treatment of patient J2057, it has occurred to me that we must fashion a mental safety mechanic that will instantly secure the consciousness of a restorer. Mental safety mechanic? Secure the consciousness of a restorer. What does that mean, to secure the consciousness of a restorer? I guess the restorer can be in danger? Speaking with Dr. Collins, we were able to define a way to contain some of the restorer's subconscious mind after the initial projection, creating a defined and contained space within the restorer's own mind, something we now refer to as the case. If we are to think of this in physical terms, I would say the metaphor of a safe would suit quite well. A space to hold the raw essence of the restorer's mind, so if the worst happens, we have an origin point to work back from. Okay, so I'm thinking the restorer, when they're inside of someone's mind, I'm making a lot of assumptions here, but I'm assuming the restorer telepathically goes into someone's mind and helps them restore their memories. So maybe if they're in someone's mind and something happens to them, the restorer themselves might get stuck in their mind, or something of them might be lost. It's dangerous in some way. Gotta keep an eye out for drawers too, because I can open them. I didn't put my keycard down, did I? What the hell's the key to look at my stuff? Oh, there it is. Nope, I got it. Whoa.
Sometimes these procedures don't, how should I put it, go to plan. But really, there's nothing to see here anyway. Shouldn't you be heading to Restoration Chamber number 3 to meet me?
Oh yeah, that's not suspicious at all. Alright, it looks like that room is broken. Some sort of machinery in the center was broken. Just sitting in some water. I think I can jump over this railing. Ugh. Come on. Oh, come on, I know you can do it. There we go. Okay, been here. Let's go back. Let's go see what's over here. Oh, that's what just happened. So it's glass that can be turned opaque or transparent. Right, so they don't want me to see whatever's in there. That's even more suspicious. Ooh. Fancy. Yeah, this game is really beautiful. And it's not that it has particularly high quality assets. I mean the textures and, you know, the detail and everything it's good, but it's just the overall graphic design just comes together and looks beautiful. I love it. Restores may only carry one item. Place keycard in the zone. Okay, yeah. I will take that, and I will put it on this thing. I'll play that in a second. Let me explore the rest of this place first. Let's leave that open just so I know I opened it. I just want to mash all of these multicolored buttons. Just press them all, see what it does. Bloop, bleep. That's a dirty window. Look at that thing. Oh my god, that chair. Oh, I can actually sit in it. Oh, that chair looks like it costs like $10,000. Can I turn on and off the light? Aw, I can't. Ether Solution 5.1. Ether Solution 5.1 has shown significant improvements over its predecessors. There is currently only a 20-to-1 chance that negative and detrimental cognitive effects will impair participants when taken regularly. Positive effects include superior long and short-term memory, which directly aids in reducing confusion and hysteria. The only major concern so far is how long the effects of the new solution lasts. High dosage can have serious effects on the liver and heart, and I fear a long-term subscription would induce similar problems within patients. All right, so they're definitely developing a drug. So the Ether Solution. So is that given to the patients that the restorers work on? So do they restore the memories of them, and then maybe they're considering giving them a solution that will have them keep the memories or something? Ooh, drawers. Ah. This one is much thinner than the other one. I wonder what it's actually to. The numbers on the front don't mean anything to me. 2.671002. Okay, well, hold on. Let's put the keycard that I need on the desk, rather than in a drawer where I might forget it, and pick up this other keycard. Come here. No, I wanna... There we go. Might as well leave this open. Okay, so what is this keycard to? That's the question. Alright, let's watch the film.
I'm incredibly excited to get started with my new patient. A real chance to explore more things and prove that they're in fact valuable.
I give that film 10 out of 10. Would watch again. Well, maybe 9 out of 10. It's kind of I'm taking a point off because it didn't actually have any visuals, which kind of defeats part of the point of a movie. It's all about moving pictures. But it wasn't bad. Alright, what is this keycard to? Wait, I think I need the other keycard to get through here. Right? Or maybe I don't? No, apparently I don't. Okay, good. I might have to, like, toggle keycards back and forth, which would have been annoying. No. Damn it. Come on, controller. No. I know I don't need the keycard for where I need to go, because I already have a keycard to the chamber 3, whatever. Restoration chamber 3? Alright, so it's not for here. Oh yeah, so that's where I need to go. Wait a minute. Isn't that where I just came from? Yeah, it is. Yeah, that's where I need to go. Wait, maybe I did need the key card from... I'm confused. What is this key card for?
The restored.
Okay, hasn't given me access to anything yet. Right. I'm gonna go grab the other key card. Oh no, apparently I need that one. If I need that keycard to get the other keycard, then... What am I supposed to do with this keycard? I wish it told me what it was for, but, like, this is completely unhelpful. I don't know what those numbers mean. Am I just supposed to guess what it's for? There's no way there's two keycards that have different shapes for nothing. There's gotta be something to do with them. Unless they're the same keycard. They even have the same numbers. They even have the same numbers, don't they? I think they might just be the same freaking keycard. Why would there be two of the same keycards? I don't know. Whatever. I think it's time to go to the restoration chamber. Maybe it's just realism? Because there would, in reality, be more than one of the same keycard. I don't see why you'd need it, though, because the only way you can get there is if you already have the keycard, right? Or maybe not. Maybe you could get there without the keycard, so it's just, yeah, an extra one, just in case. Let's not overcomplicate things, it's probably very simple. Restoration chambers 1 to 2. Looks like someone's using it as a storage room. Yeah, restoration chamber 1 to 2 is not very useful. Let's pack it full of barrels and boxes. And make what appears to be a fort. Actually, this literally looks like a fort. Has somebody been living here? Hello? Anybody home? Yeah, I mean, cushions, boxes for the floor, suitcase. Somebody's been here. Looks like somebody was staying here. Weird. Brings up a good question. Where is everyone? Where is everyone? Alright, that's where I need to go. So let's go this way. If I can. Yes, I can. Science. Many sciencey tools. What is that? Whoa. I think I'm gonna be sick. No, but seriously, what is that? It's like ST1845? I feel like I should write that down. I'm not even quite sure what that is. Is it like a crumpled piece of paper? Or just a messed up texture? I don't know. But I do have a fresh sheet of paper here on my desk for solving puzzles, for writing things down, so I'm gonna write it down just in case. Probably means nothing. but just in case. There we go. Restructuring memory, cognitive psychology. Oh crap, I didn't want to pick it up. The skeletal system, with a particular focus on the brain, or the head, not surprising. Wait a minute, this trash can, does it say the same thing? Do all the trash cans say ST1845? That's weird. Report projection malfunction. Okay. Due to a bad projection, R157 has suffered severe hemorrhaging in the brain. This has resulted in a minor stroke impacting our patient's motor abilities. The investigation is still underway, although evidence points to a fault within the cerebral component of the restoration chair. Patient R157 is currently in the recovery chamber, and depending upon treatment, may have sustained damage to memory functions. A bad projection. Does that mean a restorer messed up? Well, evidence points to a fault within the cerebral component of the restoration chair, so I guess probably not. Faulty components. I'm still wondering if I am actually a restorer or a restoree. And also, of course, since we're dealing with memories, I have to wonder whether this is even real. Maybe this is just a reconstruction of some sort. Obvious possibility. Ooh, almost missed that note. It's white amongst a very white table. Attention all staff. New restoration chambers with state-of-the-art projection chairs were installed last week. It is important to note that there are new procedures that will come up with this technology, and it is important that each and every one of you comply with these rules. We do not want another staff fatality at this institution. There's a restoration chair.
Beautiful, isn't it? A miracle of the 20th century. A window into the minds of others and a tool to cure disease and illness. But it would be nothing without the likes of you.
Okay, so I'm definitely supposed to be one of the restorers.
Right. Would you be a dear and help me with the setup? I need the electrical input for the Rembrandt installation rerouting. You can access it from that terminal over there.
Yep, this piece of equipment would be nothing without me. So I'm apparently gifted. Restorers may only carry one item. Alright. So I believe this is probably the fuse that had the wrong kind put in. Maybe? The practical joke? Might be. Either way, I know that's the wrong type, so I'll just shove that there. Only accepts 300 amp fuses. Okay. Does this say what amperage it is? Hold on, can I examine? Okay, yeah, 75 amp fuse. Okay, so it's just the wrong amperage. I suppose that means I could turn it on and it'd probably explode, right? A 75 amp fuse and a 300 amp thing would just blow it. Do I want to do that, though? I don't think I do. Maybe something special would happen. Probably not. Oh, I can't put it back. Okay. I guess I'll just swap it with one of these. Thornton Jean, 69 years old, female, British citizen, blood type is A, ID number, she's a teacher, born in Pinwheel, unknown relationship, and unknown next of kin. Notes, migrated to the USA in her 20s, only to return to the UK about 7 years ago. Still retains a British passport and has been confirmed to have been working as a teacher in Arizona for the past 30 years. Since returning, she has been residing in her town of birth, Pinwheel, Cornwall. Okay, so is that one of the people we've been trying to restore the memories of? That's my guess. Oh, it's also about Thornton, Jean Thornton. Mm-hmm, Restoration 219. Service done by Dr. Phyllis Edmonds, that's a woman that's been talking to me. Oh, yep, she is a patient. She has dementia with Lewy bodies? I don't know what that means. Alright, so her mind is starting to go, and we're trying to help her. Recommended treatment, the blah 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 solution, subscription, and restoration therapy. Okay, so yeah, it looks like their method of treatment is to use the telepathic people to attempt to go into their minds and help them. And also give them that solution, the ether solution, which is supposed to help with their memory. Leave these open. Okay, 300 amp fuse. Oh, found it. That was easy. God, I just love the sound design. The footsteps sound so good. Let's close that back up, pick up my key card, and I'm assuming I press the big red button. If I want to. But I guess I have to. Hold on, I don't think I actually tried this door. I'm sure it doesn't open. But just in case. Yeah, it doesn't open. Okay. Alright, here we go.
Right, a few things before we project. Our client, Jean, is currently in a very delicate state. Our primary focus is to ensure that we clear this area of her mind from the plaque buildup that is causing the disease. In order to do that from within, we're going to need to use her own memories to reinforce the medical treatment she's receiving.
Thank you.
worry about it. We all get used to change eventually, don't we?
Oh, is that water stuff that you can breathe in? I don't remember what it's called. It might not even be water. I remember there's some sort of a liquid you can breathe in. Whoa.
Surroundings. It keeps most restorers' sanity intact. For a short while, anyway.
Press back button to travel to the case and back. Oh, there is a back button on a controller. Huh. The tiny little black button right to the left of the center. Interesting. I didn't even know that existed on a controller. Alright, so I remember that being mentioned in notes. The case. Does it want me to press the back button right now? Okay. I'll press it. Whoa. So if I press it again, do I just... Wait, so is this the case or is the other place the case?
Our sole purpose this evening is to track the memory and pinpoint its location so we can cleanse it of any disease present. Everything you're seeing in front of you is a visual environment pieced together from our client's subconscious mind. Barren wastelands, or an abstract painting reimagined. It's all completely tangible. All I can see are brain scans of tissue degradation confirming my previous diagnosis of dementia. Both are incredibly important if we are to succeed and understand our client's needs. Now, if you just give me a second, I'll have some more details for you. Feel free to explore in the meantime.
Okay, so this is her memory, so this is my special place. My case. To keep my sanity intact. Oh, you know what? This reminds me of Myst. This really reminds me of Myst for some reason. Not that the gameplay is really very similar, but I don't know, just the fact that I'm looking at water, I guess. And I'm kind of in a different world. Look at that view. Beautiful. I love how colorful the world is. It's that semi-stylized look again. It's a bit more colorful than reality would actually be. It's a bit stylized, but it's not too much. It's not like too cartoony. But it's just, it's really beautiful. Looks like I'm having a little picnic. Is that beer? Wine? Whoa, specular map. Is that a specular map? I'm not sure. Reflection thingy. Oh, I actually took it with me. Can I put it back down? Oh no, I can't put it back down. Wait a minute, can I take it with me? Can I take items from my special place? Again. What is that? Oh, it's a harmonica? Can I play it? How'd I play it? Can't think of any way I would play it. Ooh, what does that say? Crap, flip over. Flip over. How do I do this? It's too complex, I can't handle it. Bailey's harmonicas. I can't think of a way I could possibly play this. Oh yeah, that's right, there's a zoom in key too. Forgot about that. That doesn't do it, no. Would the numbers on the keyboard do it? No. I think I can just switch the keyboard, right? Yeah, you can actually just switch straight to the keyboard and mouse from the controller. Just seamlessly switches between them, which is pretty cool. Anyway, back to the controller. It's weird, I don't seem to have any food on the picnic. I guess I've eaten it already. With that, or I'm just an alcoholic and only like alcohol. Well, it's like Aztecian or something? Neat. I imagine there's skeletons in there. Skeletons and zombies. It's okay, I'm pretty sure later in the game is when you level up and get your sword, right? And get some fireball spells. Yeah, that'll happen. Totally. Devlin Mine. Okay, this is seriously reminding me of Myst. Just the fact that it's an adventure-type game and I'm on an island, I think? I could just be on the coast, it might not be an island. Ooh, what's over here? Secrets? I wonder if I can fall down. This is the exact same place that was back there. This little shelter thing. The pillows, the cardboard boxes, the suitcase. I don't believe I can open up any of these things. Nah, I can't open it up. Also, there's a shoe. Not a pair of shoes, just one shoe. It's weird. That water seems disturbingly green. I wouldn't want to drink it. Or maybe I would. Maybe it tastes like lemon lime. Mmm. So is this entire place my special place, or is it just back here? I think this entire place is my special place. Because it doesn't take me back to the picnic, it just takes me back to wherever I last was. And it seems to work the same way here. I think this will just take me to wherever I was, right? If I move off to the side... No, okay, it does reset my position. Alright. I didn't realize my special place was so... big. Ah, this game really is beautiful. So I wonder if there's anything I can do around here, or if it's just a place to look at stuff. My safe place. Look at that view. That is some beautiful water. Sound of the seagulls. I feel like I could stay here for a while. And just look out and listen. Whoa. This place seems kind of industrial, too. Big pipes and old barrels and a freaking gas mask. Gas mask and a piece of toast. Pinwheel Industrial Tin Exports Plummet. All hopes on U.S. export deal. Hundreds of jobs are at risk as the local tin and arsenic export quantities lower dramatically within the European territory. All hopes are pinned on the successful closing of a U.S. export deal that would secure the company for the foreseeable future. The closure of Pinwheel Industrial would have devastating consequences on the small mining town of Pinwheel, where the economy relies greatly on the exports of tin, arsenic, and cider. Wait a minute. Is this my safe place, or is this her memories? I'm feeling like this is my safe place. I mean, this is my hub, right? Pinwheel Harbor. I'm kind of confused. Let's explore this place for a little bit then. When the mind thinks, the heart transmits. Or sorry, what the mind thinks, the heart transmits. Some numbers here. It could matter. 1944. I'm gonna write that down. Okay, what's down here? Okay, yeah, this is definitely my safe place. I can even do some weightlifting in my mind. Something tells me that won't transmit to real improvement of my muscles in the real world. I lift weights, man, in my mind. Place of comfort. Looks like somebody needs to... I need to wash the dishes of my mind. That's gotta be some sort of a metaphor, right? Even in my safe place, I'm unclean. This oven's rusty. Oh well, who cares? I don't think I need to eat. Ooh. Oh my god. Oh, it's locked. Okay, are they all locked? They are. There's gotta be some way to unlock them, obviously. Maybe that's what the puzzles do. Ooh. Another harmonica. Again, I don't think I can play it, though. What's in there? Ooh, this is my first puzzle. Wait, it just has one number? That can't be right. Is it missing the rest of the pieces? Gotta be missing the rest of the pieces or something, right? A one number safe would be kind of ineffective. That'll probably make sense later, I'm hoping. Oh, that is an old style toilet. I don't even know how you flush it. How do you flush that? Okay, one place left to go. Ooh. Laboratory. Laboratorium. Lunar illumination. Alright, so I'm guessing I'm gonna be doing stuff with this. With this equipment later. Oh wait, what about the fridge? Oh, I can't open it. Man, all the trash cans say something something 1845. The fact that it's on all the trash cans makes me think that it probably doesn't matter then. Okay, let's go back. Right, so we're back in Jean Thornton's, right? Yeah, Jean Thornton's memories. Such an idiot. Oh god, I'm such an idiot. I borrowed the air compression manual in order to make repairs in the mine, and I left it down past the blast doors. Steve has warned me so many times about being forgetful. I just hope I can get it back before it gets lost forever. I can't afford for any of my wage to be docked this week. Dan. Air compression manual. Alright, so apparently it's left down in the mines past the blast doors. I think maybe I should write this down, because I don't think I have a to-do list, or quest goals, or anything like that. Air comp manual in mines. There we go. Alright, a lot of gas masks. I guess what they're exporting, or trying to produce arsenic, or whatever, is probably pretty nasty. Pretty sure arsenic is a nasty chemical.
It's worth noting that if you feel an item might be useful later on in your journey, and you have no use for it now, you can always store it in the case and collect it at any time. Should you want to.
Whoa. Fletch. Well, given that it says Fletch on the bottom, and given what you just said, I'm guessing I'm supposed to store this. Okay. Something tells me that's not going to be helpful. I don't know, maybe it will be. Never know. Can I store this piece of toast? I think it holds clues in the burn patterns on it. What secrets does the lighthouse hold? I guess I'm going to find out, because I think I'm going to go to it. Special church service. In preparation for Pinwheel's May Day celebrations, Father D. Wolstenholm will be holding a special service at Pinwheel Church. The service will commence at midday and will conclude with the ringing of the tower bells. New health and safety mining laws to come into effect soon. Be sure to check with your mining warden to get up to date with the new laws, for your safety and the safety of your co-workers. Bell's inventions breathe fresh air into Pinwheel. Bell's inventions. Whoa. How do I get down there? Ooh, music. Get some tunes while I'm searching. I didn't actually want to take that, but oh well. Okay, let's go upstairs. Think I can read any of that? No. Wait a minute, don't I have a painting from the same author back at my place? The one with the lighthouse? I think it had the same red symbol on it, didn't it? Yeah. Why is that here? I mean, my case is independent of this, right? Maybe it's not. Maybe they're kind of connected. I don't know. I mean, my case does have these things, which are obviously connected to the memory. The memories. So, maybe there's some bleed over. Whoa. D11. Probably means something. Write it all down. You never know. Whoa, zoom in. Unease in the mine. Mr. Morin, it has come to my attention during my inspection of the mining facilities here at Devlin that many of the workers in the pit are unsettled, uneasy, and as a result, unproductive. There is clearly a correlation between the pitiful working conditions that these men have to endure, and their motivation to do productive and worthwhile work. Lifts and descent devices are clearly in disrepair. Ventilation in the chambers below are blocked, causing fume and smoke buildup. With these issues and more in mind, it is with my sincere apologies that I have decided the Devlin Mine should close temporarily until these issues meet the standards required by your governing union body. Workplace safety issues. Not good. Okay, check out back.